My name is Cheah Sui Huat. I was known in the heritage circle as Peter Cheah. I'm the chairman of Sacred Tong Cheah Kongsi.
I'm Chee Seong. I'm an architect and I'm a founder of ALM Architect.
In the olden days, the Cheah Kongsi ancestral hall is set up to for the purpose of paying respect to the ancestor and also to the patron deity, and it is also a place for the Cheah clan members to congregate annually for the annual grand winter solstice dinner. This building has undergone a series of repairs and restoration. If I'm not wrong, it's about four times. But this is the first time where we have undertook a very major restoration since the completion in 1873. The state of the temple, the roof are leaking. Many original sculptures or feature of the Kongsi was distorted.
Actually, one of our interesting projects is Cheah Kongsi restorations. This is actually the only one Category A heritage building which is carried out at this moment. First of all, we have to respect the history. So some of the history, in fact, is not the original story of the building. We also do some very minor amendments to the existing building to restore it back to the original positions. There is some Malay motif in the building, where it's actually introduced by one of the committee from Kedah State. We decided to keep that element in to tell the story to our next generations that our building is actually a mixture of a different culture. For example, there is a window at the administration's building, which is a Malay architecture. And also we have a fascia box at the roof edge, where it's actually origin from Malay carving.
We are originally from China, southern China, Xiamen. So our contractors are also from the Fujian province. So the craftsmen, we try to get those related to the... Because we are a Hokkien institution. So we try to put back as much old architecture and heritage features as possible. They specialize in roof and cut and paste jian nien, chai hui, and also the roof tiles. You see, that building line is the previously the double story brick house. Double-story brick house, which was demolished, you see. After it was caught for fire, it was demolished. And on the left is a single-story plank house. We would like to know, we don't intend to paint the wall because it becomes a natural art mural. It's very true that from records, there is a double-story house in front, you see. And then I was told, but there's no material evidence to say that I was told that it was bombed during the Second World War for commercial use. Or it could be the then trustees are doing business down here. So that's why they start building a shop lot in front, you see. And the Kongsi does not intend to rebuild the house because we have plans to make this place open courtyard, you see. So that we can house our, not only for our annual activities and festival, we can also let the communities, we can also plan for the communities to use this lawn. You see?
We are thinking of building back a very abstract skeleton of the existing building, which illustrates the form and the space feeling of the original building. But at the same time, we maintain the see-through feeling so that the clan building, the Cheah Kongsi's building, can have their frontage towards this street, can make this area as a gathering area, as a public space, or as a space for them to hang around while enjoying the heritage building. I would like to call it a progressive conservation for this type of thinking. Like the design that I proposed for Cheah Kongsi is a challenge not only to me, but it is to the conservation community. Whether this type of idea can be a trend or not. So if yes, then how should we regulate it? If not, how should we tolerate ourselves to a different context of design?